I will share 8 fluoroscopic guided sacroiliac joint injection cases in this episode. No single historical, physical exam or radiological feature can definitively establish a diagnosis of sacroiliac joint pain. Therefore, based on present knowledge, a proper diagnosis can only be made using controlled diagnostic blocks. Unfortunately, although the sacroiliac joint is large, it cannot be easy to enter due to its complex nature and variations in individual anatomy. Nevertheless, in clinical practice, I have observed that the inferior recess approach is the highest success rate compared to lower one-third targeting or other approaches in the sacroiliac intra-articular injection techniques. Targeting the lower one-third of the bony sacroiliac joint is the most popular technique. There are several disadvantages to this technique. It looks easy and clear, but the lucent double line of the joint is usually a fake. So, you normally contact the bone first and then move the needle for some time. You must creep the needle in various directions until to feel to get the needle into the joint, so you must anesthetize the area before the procedure. Also, intra-articular injections will take a lot of time, and the mean fluoroscopy time was reported to be about 1.56 minutes. Furthermore, there is a high risk of contrast contamination or technical failure. I will show you the inferior recess of the sacroiliac joint before sharing the cases. It is a synovial outpouching from the distal margin of the bony sacroiliac joint. Usually, the iliac bone covers the sacral bone at the inferior tip of the joint. However, several variations of the inferior tip of the bony sacroiliac joint exist. I will zoom in on the inferior aspect of the bony sacroiliac joint and show the variation schematic drawing. The yellow plate is the iliac bone, and the blue plate is the sacral bone. The alignment of the joint line will be inferior lateral oblique, vertical, or inferior medial oblique directions. It is easy if the iliac side is shorter than the sacral side, allowing it to open wide the inferior joint space. But the iliac side is sometimes longer than the sacral side, making it challenging. Any bone spur on the sacral or iliac side will block the gateway. So, watching the bony anatomy before introducing the needle would be best. There is another tip for a successful sacroiliac joint injection. Although the needle tip may appear in the side on fluoroscopy, the contrast dye spread may not indicate. In addition, once the contrast dye is injected, fluoroscopic landmarks are obscured by the injected contrast dye. So make sure you are in the right place. Once the tip of the needle is correctly placed, its position is checked under continuous fluoroscopy while moving the C-arm in the right and left oblique directions. On dynamic fluoroscopy, the needle tip should remain within the joint line and not appear outside of the joint line. If the tip of the needle appears to be on the bone out of the joint line, it is not the correct space. Please watch repeatedly, it will give you the insight to delineate the joint line. Enjoy the show. It is the first case. It is the second case. It is the third case. It is the fourth case. It is the fifth case. It is the sixth case.
Thank you.
It is the seventh case. It is the eighth case. Thank you for watching. See you in the following videos.